My mother always talked to us about God. She couldn't have survived without faith in God. We were in so many situations that were ridiculous and impossible. We always struggled growing up financially, and without God, we wouldn't have been able to pay our bills. We wouldn't have been able to feed our family. We wouldn't have been able to have Christmas. So we had a lot of help from people who loved God and reached out to our family and were very kind. And I had this impression that God was kind. But it was that same year that my cousin was murdered, beaten to death by his stepfather. And I couldn't wrap my mind around this idea that God would allow something so violent and horrible to happen to someone so small and innocent and beautiful. So I decided to stop believing in God. And that same year, I also decided that I would be sad for him, that I would commit to be loyal to my cousin's death and what he had to go through. It wasn't fair that I was still alive and that he had died. And just a strange thing, I think, for a 10-year-old to try to figure out how to mourn and not really know how. Anytime I would be happy, I would try to remind myself again, no, you can't be happy, you need to be sad. So I did the opposite and thought about things that were sad and depressing and ugly, and really started to hate people because I felt like they were naive. If they were happy, they didn't know anything about life, and how can you be happy in a world where children die? And by the time I was 16, I was so worn out from my hatred. I was so worn out from my sin, and realized that I didn't want to live anymore, and that I finally found a reason to justify not living, and thinking that if I did die, I would make life better for my family. And so when I was 16, I made a plan to commit suicide, and that's the reason that I wanted to die.